Hi, welcome to Pavvo's play-by-play, where I take you through a different iOS game every session. Okay, for this week, we're going to take a look at another case solved by Chillingo Games. It was released last week. It's also by this group of a company called AT Games. If you've played Puzzlecraft before, well, the gameplay is very, very similar. A bit of background about the game before we start. You play a private detective in this world where sugar is banned, so all the local authorities are busy catching criminals who, you know, are involved with sugar crimes, and all the little petty theft and missing persons case gets ignored, and that's where you come in, where you try and solve all these different cases. The gameplay is very similar to Puzzlecraft if you played it before. It's a little bit like a match tree. I'll just jump right into the game and I'll come back and I'll explain all the different nuances. I'll just play a simple game that we played before. Each game requires you to, each of these main missions require a specific number of mini missions in order to complete them. Okay? And how you get mini missions is, you know, earned through these newspaper icons at the top left of the screen. I'll just jump right into a game that I previously played. The gameplay is deceptively simple. Okay, what you have to do is you have to collect clues and evidence to move on. You have 20 moves in this instance to get all the necessary clues and evidence. What you need to get is listed at the top of the screen. Okay, you can see the little silhouettes with the people, little speech bubbles, and those are what you need to get in order to move on. Okay, so for this instance, for a start, I need to get 5 footprints, 1 map, and 15 question mark icons. Okay, on the left, you could see the clues and the evidence. Okay, the number of clues and evidence you've gathered so far in this case. Evidence, you don't really see them on the board yet. In order to get the evidence, you have to connect 5 or more of the corresponding clues. Okay, so to get maps, you need 5 or more footprints. To get fingerprints, you need 5 or more magnifying glasses, so on and so forth. Below that, you see a list of your skills and the tools. Okay, tools are one-off. You can only use them that number of times before you have to purchase them again with in-game cash. Skills are given to you every game. Okay, it tells you how many times you can use them, and some of them have a cost, which are clues or evidence based. Okay, so I'll just fast forward through the game just to give you a big quick example of how it's being played. After you're done collecting the clues and evidence, you will be tasked with 3 different mini games in order to complete the case. Okay, so each game will allow you to use the evidence which you've gathered in the main game in order to try and figure out who the suspects are, or where they're staying, or where they fit in that particular item. So in this case, I've got to find who knows something about the donuts, and how I do that is I ask them questions based on the options here on the left. So for example, I could ask whether the suspect is a man or a woman. It's a man, so I can eliminate these 4. And I have 1 question left. I can ask whether he has a mustache. Yes, so that eliminates him. The game continues like this, case after case. You solve cases, and with each case you solve, you get stars. I've already solved this case. So for each case that you solve, you get stars, which you can see as the top right is how you advance in level. And what you can do with the stars is, if you tap on the notice board, okay, you can advance your skills, which allow you to collect different sets of evidences together with clues, gives you more time, whole bunch of cool stuff. Okay. You also get money, and what you can use money for, okay, you can buy furniture to dress up your room. Of course, if they're not just cosmetic, you earn more in-game benefits like more money or more equipment. And of course, there are candy. This is a free game, so candy is the main form of IAP in this game. And what you use candy for is, if sometimes you are not able to complete a particular case within the time limit, candy sort of gives you more time to do it. Okay. I also talked about prerequisites. The newspapers up there are prerequisites to get you the main quest. So if you have a stack of newspapers here on the floor, if you tap them, okay, you see they give you a little reward, and tap on this and you play the actual game again, but without all the little mini games of finding the suspects or finding out the locations. Okay. And of course you can customize your appearance here. Alright, so that's another case solved. What do I think of it? I think it's a very unique twist on the match tree genre. If you played Puzzlecraft before, that was an absolutely brilliant game, and really got into that a lot, and I suspect that I will get into this a lot too. You can get a copy of Another Case Solved from the iTunes store. It's currently free to play. I will include a link to the game at the bottom of this video. So until next time, this has been Pavvo's Play-by-Play. Thank you for watching.